World Malaria Day is observed on the 25th of April. Usually, the day is seen as an opportunity to celebrate the progress in the fight against malaria. But this year, it is to sound the alarm. Heavy rainfall in Pakistan and the African nation of Malawi has resulted in an increase in the number of malaria infections and deaths. As per the World Health Organization, cases in Pakistan last year, after devastating floods left a third of the country underwater, rose fourfold to 1.6 million. Meanwhile, in Malawi, Cyclone Freddy triggered rainfall worth 6 months in just 6 days. In both these countries, the pools of water left behind created ideal breeding grounds for malaria-carrying mosquitoes. Peter Sands, head of the Global Fund to Fight AIDS, Tuberculosis and Malaria, said that this was real evidence of the impact of climate change, the climate change impact on malaria. He said that the dramatic increase in cases illustrates the need to get ahead of the issue. He said, and I quote, "If malaria is going to be made worse by climate change, we need to act now to push it back and eliminate it." In 2021, the WHO said that there were an estimated 247 million cases of malaria worldwide. It also said that 619,000 deaths could be attributed to malaria. Peter Sands said that there was a need to ensure that the health systems in countries are made more resilient. Earlier this month, Ghana became the first country to approve a new malaria vaccine developed by the Oxford University. This is a step forward in the fight against the disease that kills thousands of children every year. Oxford has a deal with Serum Institute of India to produce up to 200 million doses of the vaccine known as R21 annually. The WHO is yet to give its approval for the vaccine.
This is a single component vaccine. Our overall program at Oxford is aiming to produce a multi-component vaccine that won't be ready in the next year or two, but eventually we may be able to improve that efficacy level of 77% right up into the 90s if we can add some more components. But it's really only then you might even begin to think about stopping using other interventions. So certainly not yet.